$6,000, a lot of money.
You think so? Wait until you see what offer they come back with.
It's all right for you.
What do you mean, love?
He was going to let me go with all that money and she told him no.
I didn't tell him no. I just said that we wanted more money. Well, surely you can see that $500,000's better than $50,000.
All I can see that $50,000 is better than nothing. A fat chance I've got now of an early retirement. You never even asked me what I thought.
Etty, you haven't got the faintest idea how those people think. I'm just trying to get you what's owing to you. You could show a bit of appreciation.
All I can appreciate is spending the rest of my life in here. All he wanted me to do was to sign that letter, and you wouldn't let me, and now I'll never get out.
When did this arrive?
Yesterday. It was in the box when I arrived home last night.
It's true, there'll be hell to pay. I wish Joan was here. I want to give her a chance to defend herself before I pass it on to the department. But if I hang on for too long and it leaks out some other way, I'll be accused of a cover-up.
Well, I just can't think of any reason why Ray'd lie.
Neither can I.
I've been thinking too.
Yeah?
About us getting married. You're going to be inside for another year, but I'm out in a few months. And we might not be able to see each other much or anything.
You want to call it all off?
No! Matthew, I want to do it while we're still together. I want to get married on the inside. What do you reckon?
Hey, guess what?
You're late. We started work 15 seconds ago.
Oh, come on. This is the best, most rippest news ever.
Oh, don't tell me. Let me guess. The freak is going to run off with Frank Burke.
Oh, Jude, I'm serious.
Okay, what is this fabulous news you got for us?
Me and Matthew have decided to get married right here in Wentworth.
When?
As soon as we can get permission, all the arrangements are made. Isn't that great? Well, isn't it?
I think it's dumb.
Why?
So do I.
What do you want to get married in this dump for?
I've heard of plenty of girls getting married inside.
Only because they've got no other choice.
Well, neither have I.
Oh, rubbish. You haven't got all that long to serve.
I have some.
Come on, what's a couple of months out of the lifetime you and Matt have ahead of you?
Stages.
It isn't. You're jumping the gun because you're too bloody impatient. Whose idea was it?
It was both our ideas.
Well, I think you should both go away and think about it. Have you any idea what married life is like in here?
Great.
Oh, yes. How do you think Matt is going to feel making love to you in the conjugal rights suite with the women jeering and screaming obscenities?
Oh, God, it's not very fair on the guy. It's no way to start a life together.
Well, it's my life and I'll do what I want.
It's Matt's life too, you know.
Oh, great. I thought you'd both be thrilled. This way you can all be at the wedding. We can have a great time and it'd be great fun.
It's a nice thought, Rabbit. But a wedding is not an excuse to have a great time. It is not just another party. I think you should go away and think again very carefully.
Well, now she thinks we're a couple of ogres.
Yeah. Where's Janice? She's supposed to be working.
Search me.
Eddie, any idea where Janice is?
No, and I couldn't care less.
Sorry I asked.
Right then, how about roast pork and stuffed apples?
No.
What do you mean no?
Well, you mean leg of pork. Several legs of pork.
Why not?
Because there isn't any. Pork's too expensive. They're not going to waste it on cribs.
How about lamb? Lamb's okay, isn't it?
Yeah, fine with me.
Legs?
Why not?
Well, that settles it then. Lamb it is. Look, go to the cool room and see what we've got then.
Oh, not again. It's the fifth time I've been in there. I'll end up with frostbite.
Off you go. I can't cook the evening meal unless I know all the ingredients are there. Right, now, it's 40 meals, right?
Yeah, wouldn't worry about the screws.
So that means I'll need, 8 serves to the leg. Or is it 6?
6 would mean we'd get more.
6 it is then. So that means I'll need, about 7 legs, right?
Right.
Wrong.
Why?
because there's only one leg of lamb left in there.
Really?
Really.
Oh, well, that puts a spanner in the works, doesn't it? I'll tell you what, anybody got any suggestions? None of mine seem to be working.
Oh, you don't seem to be working. Look, I've been running around looking for this and looking for that, and now you're asking for suggestions from us.
And why not?
Because you're the cook. You're supposed to be in charge. You're supposed to know these things.
I know. I was just trying to get you all involved, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, sure.
She's dying.
What are you talking about? Who is?
Jan.
What do you mean?
Look, I found her in her cell. She's double over in pain. She's really sick. I went down and got Mrs. Morris and they've taken her to the infirmary. She's dying.
Terrible thing, death.
She been drinking anything?
I don't know.
Well, it's all my fault.
Well, how is it your fault?
Well, it always is. I get things muddled up and people end up dead. I gave Samantha the wrong message and she died. And now I've got something muddled up with Jan and... Isn't that right, Myra? It's my fault that Jan's died?
No, love, it's not. She's not dead. Some people just don't have any guts, that's all. She wants to be a drunk, that's her funeral.
How is she?
Very weak. The doctor's just left with a sample for analysis. We've pumped her stomach and given her a maxillin injection to stop the vomiting.
So has the doctor diagnosed the problem?
Well, he believes it's a poison with some sort of spirit base, probably methyl alcohol. He'll be phoning through the results soon, so we'll know for certain then.
She's not in any danger, is she? Oh,
she's very ill, but all the normal procedures for this sort of case have been administered.
But she'll be all right.
I don't know. Mrs. Reynolds, I've been going through Jan's medical record. Did you realize that since she was inducted, she's lost nearly a stone in weight?
I had no idea.
I'm very worried. I don't think the normal treatment will be enough. I mean, she's so weak from not eating properly. Well, I think there's some sort of psychological problem as well.
What sort of psychological problem?
Her will to live. Unless she fights, we're going to have a very serious problem on our hands.
Furniture polish.
That's the result of the analysis that came back from the hospital. Now, why would Jan bring furniture polish?
Search me.
Doesn't it strike you as odd?
Maybe.
Maybe. Myra, I want to know what's going on. No one would drink that stuff unless they were forced to. Her weight loss alone shows that someone's been heavying her. Now, who is responsible?
Is she going to be all right?
I don't know. She's very weak, and she seems to have lost her will to live.
I see. This furniture polish, was it alcohol-based?
Yes, why?
Maybe I should have told you this before. Nobody has been heavying her. Just the opposite, in fact. We've all tried to help her. Obviously, to no avail.
Help her in what way? Are you suggesting she's an alcoholic?
Yes.
Then why didn't you tell me?
She begged us not to. She promised she would kick the habit.
And you believed her?
Yes. Besides, we couldn't lag.
Well, I hope you're all very proud of yourselves. Jan could die as a result of your sacred code of no lagging. That'll be all. Yes? Just a moment. One more thing, Desmond. Something like alcoholism requires proper medical treatment. We are in a position to help. You are not. Next time something like this happens, I want to be informed. Understood?
Yes, understood.
Sorry.
Who?
Mr. Proctor? Yes, show him through.
Talk about slow. Why doesn't he use a bigger frying pan, cook the whole lot at once?
Because he's dumb. That bloke's ever cooked for more than two or three people in his life, I'll eat Boy George's bow. Guess what?
Dinner is cancelled.
You're joking, I'm starving.
Oh, what's the buzz?
Jan drank some poison. They reckon what? She's gonna die.
Poison?
Yep, the screws are gonna get pretty heavy about it too.
Where'd she get it from?
Dunno, but I suppose they'll find out. Unless she dies first.
What sort of poison?
Search me.
Hey, Merv, your wrist holes are burning.
Give me one of those. Don't tell anyone, please. Give me a chance.
Any change in Jan's condition?
Afraid not. Sister Hall's keeping a constant check on her, but there's been no improvement.
I just had a visit from Ray Proctor.
Oh?
Yes. He seemed quite anxious to talk about Joan and the letter until I told him he'd probably have to appear at the hearing.
And?
He refused to talk about it any further, said he wasn't going to appear at any kind of hearing, and left.
Then we're no further ahead.
Oh. Unless we can contact Rebecca Keane or get Joan in to answer the charges.
Oh, well, we both know Joan and deny everything. No, talking to Keane's the only alternative, but will her evidence carry any weight?
I don't know.
Would the letter be enough for the department?
Perhaps. But it's a delicate situation.
Yes, especially if Ray won't testify.
Yes, and if we don't tread very carefully, we could have a libel suit on our hands. And wouldn't Joan just love that? Mm. Where did you get the drink from, Jan?
I found it.
Someone had to give it to you. I must know who.
I'm not lagging. It wasn't their fault. I made them.
But how could you drink such a thing?
I had to. You don't understand. I'm an alcoholic.
Why didn't you come to me? Jan, can you hear me? Why did you drink that stuff knowing it could have killed you? Didn't you realize it was poison? We'll talk later. Get some rest.
No more now. You rest.
Poison?
Shh, rest.
You're not a cook, are you? What are you up to?
Nothing. Well, I am a cook. Well, what they call a cold larder chef in big kitchens. I've never had to cook for such large numbers, and I've never actually been in charge. People always told me what to do.
That figures. How'd you get the job, then?
Well, I wanted it, so I doctored a couple of references.
Ah, you told a little white lie, eh?
Little, huh?
So to speak.
Yeah, well, I reckon it was bigger than little and darker than white.
Well, actually, I made a pretty good job of it.
And now you can't handle it.
Well, if given a chance, I'll learn to.
Oh, yeah, sure.
I really am a good cook, really. And I really want this job. I need it. I've just got to get over the phobia for cooking for large numbers, that's all. I am a good cook, really.
Oh, how am I going to cope with another wimp in this place? Don't be unfair, Lex. Everyone deserves one go at least. Don't worry about it, Murph. We'll cover for you.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I really appreciate that. Oh, oh, not again.
Oh, what on earth's going on here?
Oh, it's all my fault, Mrs.
Yes, well, that doesn't surprise me, Warren. Will you come with me? Your parents are here to see you. Oh. Don't just stand there, Patterson. Help Mr. Pringle. That's if you want any dinner tonight.
Listen, Pet, your mother and I are very concerned about this engagement of yours to this fella.
His name is Matthew. Matthew Delaney.
Now, don't misunderstand us. We've got nothing against him.
We don't even know him.
It's just that we feel you're rushing into it a bit.
I know what I want. I'm old enough to make my own mind up.
We're not saying you're not, love.
But how many times have you dived headlong into something only to change your mind 5 minutes later?
Marriage isn't something that you should rush into, Marley.
I know what I'm doing. I reckon you've got it in for Matt because he's in jail.
Pet, that isn't true. It's just that we feel you're a bit too young to get married.
Oh, very funny. I'm the same age as Mum was when she married you.
Look, it took us years to get to know each other, to sort our problems out. That's why we're so worried.
You sorted them out, didn't you? You're still together.
Yes, well, we were lucky. But we nearly broke up several times. In our day, we didn't have the same sort of pressures that you kids have to face.
We wouldn't have survived it today. Luckily, it was a few years after we were married that you came along. If we'd had that extra pressure early on in our marriage, we'd have broken up for sure.
You're joking.
No, we're not.
Please, love, think very carefully. Give yourselves some time.
What if we don't want to? Well,
We can't condone it, Pet. We don't agree with it for your sake.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. The one time I really need your support, you're not giving it.
All we want you to do is...
Don't worry about it. I've made up my mind and I'm going to do what I want, not what you want me to do. I love Matthew and I'm going to marry him, with or without your blessing. And what's more, I'll do it as soon as I have to. And right here, too.
If I sink this, you're a goner. That'll be two games straight.
Don't count your chickens.
I did it! I beat you! I reckon I can do just about anything now.
Best of five?
No way, I'm going to quit while I'm ahead. Oh, and you can pay me later.
All right.
How's it going, Jude?
Slowly.
I am going great guns. You know, ever since I started writing songs, I just can't seem to stop. And I've got a couple of newies I want to play for everyone, too.
Sheila, I thought we were going to keep your songwriting our little secret, you know. I mean, you just keep working on them and then you can show them to everybody when they're perfect.
Yeah, but they're good now.
Yeah, I'm sure they are, but they can be better. I mean, I'd never show my songs to anyone unless they were absolutely perfect.
Yeah, well, I suppose you're right. I'll have to go and practice then, eh? I might even write a couple of newies. See you later.
Where's Jeff?
Studying. Got an exam in a couple of weeks.
Something wrong?
Oh, I went anything right. Trying to work out who sold that poison to Jan.
Well, it shouldn't be too hard. Who's left that'd be after a quick buck?
Yeah, I know. Alice Jenkins.
Yeah, I can't believe she'd do it deliberately. It would have to be an accident.
Maybe.
Oh, hi, Ma. Wondering where you got to. Listen, I've been meaning to talk to you.
I just had a visit from Mum and Dad.
Oh, good, because what I was thinking was...
Well, don't bother. We're going to have to go ahead without them.
Eh?
We had a fight. I told them we'll get married with or without their consent.
I mean, don't you think that's not a good idea?
I don't care. I don't care if I never see them again.
Okay, what's the problem?
No problem. I'm just not going to see my parents again, that's all.
You're being a bit silly, aren't you? They love you.
Oh, sure. They love me as long as I do what they want. Well, I'm not going to. You'll still want to get married, won't you?
Yeah, well, of course. I was thinking maybe they were talking sense. Maybe they were right.
Oh, great. So now you're going to take their side too.
Oh, Ma, for God's sake. I mean, you're acting like a spoiled brat. Ma?
Well, we did it. There'll be an evening meal after all.
Yeah, no thanks to you.
I'm sorry.
Look, how long do you think we can keep covering for you?
I don't know.
Someone's bound to find out. What if the Screws decide to change the kitchen roster? What then?
Well, I hope they don't. You'll still help me, won't you?
Oh, for the minute. So long as you prove you can cook.
I promise you I'm a very good cook. Look, if I have to do a dinner party for two or four people, I can turn out the best cordon bleu meal you've ever tasted.
Then you shouldn't have any problem. All you've got to do is add the right amount of ingredients for the right amount of people.
But that's the problem. Look, when I see a big pile of ingredients, I just freeze up. I get scared and muck it up.
Well, you better learn them pretty fast, too.
Look, I will. If you'll all have a little patience with me. I promise I'll practice at home until I can cook for a whole army. I need this job, Lexi. It's my last chance to prove I can do it.
Can I come in?
Suit yourself.
Still mad at me, huh?
Oh, why should I be? First you call me a brat, then you make a fool of me in public. Nothing to get upset about.
Jeez, Ma, I do love you. It's just that you get a bit carried away sometimes, that's all.
What do you expect me to do, back down in front of my parents?
No, we'll just see their point of view. I mean, they've been there, they've done it. You should just listen to what they've got to say.
They just don't want me to marry you.
Maybe. Maybe not. We have to give them time to get used to the idea.
Do you still want to marry me?
More than anything I've ever wanted.
Oh, thank God for that. I'd have died if you'd have said no.
I just want it to be right. I want your mum and dad as well as mine to be happy.
I just want to be with you.
We've got to slow down. I'll be better in the long run, I promise. Just a couple of months. And promise me you'll make it up with your mum and dad, okay?
fault, Mrs. M.
No, it's not.
I don't care whose fault it was. You realize you could be on a charge for this?
You can't put us on a...
I can. But I won't.
Soup?
As you ordered.
Good.
Jan? Jan, wake up, dear.
Time you had something to eat.
Hi. Feeling better? Terrible accident you had.
No.
It was an accident.
No, keep her away.
Jan, please.
No, keep her away. It was no accident. First she killed Sam and now she's trying to kill me. I'm not eating that poison.
Dinner, I've had it.
Yeah, well, you nearly didn't. You should have seen poor old Merv juggling red hot saucepans of flaming tea towels and burnt ribs.
Any chance of us spending any time alone? No,
who wants to play cards?
You won me.
Well, we'll have a couple of hands and then we'll casually wander off.
You do.
Hey, I've got a great idea. An act with Sheila at the front singing and we could be doing the backup vocals and dancing.
No, I couldn't.
Oh, yes, you could. We'd make you look great. Listen to this. Frankie and Johnny were lovers. Oh, Lordy, I'll be good love. So it needs a little polish.
Yeah, it needs a lot of polish. Oh, look, no, I couldn't do it,
really. I mean, I couldn't sing in public, can I? Now, what do you mean? We're the toughest public there is, and if we think you're good, then you're probably great, right?
Right.
Hey, speaking of singing in backing vocals, Mrs. B?
Yeah?
How about a demo of that tap routine again, eh?
Oh, no, not now.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Come on. All right. Judy?
Yes.
One, two, three. Back again.
I don't think I
could. Yeah,
come on. No. I've got far too much to do at the moment.
I reckon it'd be a great idea.
You want to hear the scoop of the day?
Alice has been charged with murdering Sam and poisoning Jan.
What?
Jan lagged on her.
You sure?
Positive. How about that, eh?
Oh, penny for them.
Oh, I'm just trying to work things out. Do you honestly believe that it was Alice who killed Sam?
Well, she's virtually admitted everything by saying it's an accident. Why?
Oh, I'm just a little confused. You see, if Etty told me she was responsible for Sam's death...
Well, you can't believe that, sure.
Oh, no, of course not. But apparently she relayed a message from Burke to Myra to go to that cell, only Etty got it all mixed up as usual and told Sam.
Oh, I see. So it was Myra that Burke was trying to kill?
Yes. This is where I'm confused. Was it Alice or was it Burke?
Well, both. I mean, Alice certainly isn't denying any of it. But that's not to say that she couldn't have been in cahoots with Burke.
Stop it. I just can't stand mysteries. I should never have listened to Etty. Silly old thing. And now she's upset because I won't let her see Grant.
What's the trouble, Joyce?
Oh, no trouble. Just a bit out of breath and a bit dry in the mouth. The women want me to teach them tap dancing.
Tap dancing?
Yes. I just showed them a few steps in the rec room and... Well, they seem quite enthusiastic.
Are you serious?
Well, I wasn't, but the more I think about it, it's really not such a bad idea.
Mum and Dad are simple, hard-working folk. Honest as the day's long. You're going to love them, Mal.
I just hope they're going to love me.
Oh, I'm sure they will. I've written and told them all about you. Told them how much I love you.
Just don't want to disappoint them, that's all.
Oh, you won't.
Oh, cripes, not you two as well. Eh?
Well, I just saw Jeff and Myra sneaking off down the corridor looking for some corner to have it off in. Now you two are at it.
Well, we're just talking, Lexi.
Oh, yeah, sure, you were. I suppose you'd like me to leave, eh?
Screws are going to be here any minute, Lex.
Do you mind?
I knew it. The whole joint's gone sex crazy. It's like living in a bloody dog pound.
I really want to, Matt. I
I really want to do it with you. But you should know I've never done it before.
I don't mind. I'm old-fashioned anyway. I can wait till we're married. Can you?
I've been looking for a love that never dies, and for a man with deep, deep eyes.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm just practicing myself. I thought I'd try out what Mal said, you know, and if I ever do go professional, then at least I'll have some sort of act prepared.
No, oh, forget it. With songs like that, your only audience would be stray dogs, and even they'd run away. Tell you what, though, if you want to make yourself useful, put yourself down for skip duty in the laundry tomorrow.
See, I've got this great idea about running a book. I'm going to need a runner. Figure you'd be perfect for the job. Tell you what, I'll give you a third of the takings. Got a bit of a stake, not much, but it'll do for a start.
No way.
What?
I said no way.
You ungrateful little sod.
Me? If ever I've met anyone as selfish and ungrateful and inconsiderate to other people, it's you. I think you're a little bitch and I don't want to have anything to do with you.
Hey, Eddie, why don't you come and sing? Hey, what's wrong?
Nothing.
Well, why don't you come and sing with me?
I don't want to.
You're mad at me about something?
No.
Well, then what's wrong?
Nothing. I'm in nothing.
Now, that's not true.
Sure it is. It's all my fault. I'm a stupid old fool. I should listen to people and not argue, and then maybe people wouldn't die.
Hey, come on. I've told you, Janice is not going to die, and it's not your fault that she drank the poison.
It is. Anyway, I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to talk about nothing. That way, no one will get killed or hurt.
All right, ladies, lock up time.
Oh, God. Night, fellas. 15 minutes to lights out, yeah. Okay?
Night. Good night.
How's it going?
Okay. I think.
Good, good.
Something bugging you?
What? Sorry, Jeff. Didn't mean to disturb you or nothing.
Don't worry about it. Something is bugging you.
Yeah. Well, it's about me and Mal.
Yeah.
Well, you see, she hadn't done it before, you know. I promised I'd wait until we got married.
Well, that's really up to the both of you to decide, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, well, we have sort of promised, you know, but... Oh, geez, Jeff, I'm just not sure I can keep it.
It's a common problem.
Yeah, well, that's sort of half the problem, you see. Oh, geez, Jeff, I never done it before, neither. I mean, what happens if I mess it up? Could be disastrous for both of us, eh?
Yeah, I see.
You want a couple of lessons, sonny? Send it to me. I'll break her in for you. I'll even let you watch.
Shut up, Frank! You touch her and I'll kill you!
Oh, yeah? You and what army? What she needs is a real man.
Shut up, Burke.
Matt McCow, cocky.
I was telling you again, Burke. Shut up!
Sure.
Stitches all right?
Yeah.
How's the arm?
Fine.
So, you've completely recovered.
Yeah. Just can't wait to get back to all the happy little Vegemites.
How did you sustain those internal injuries?
Well, I was walking down the corridor one day, and a weasel got in me way. Tripped and fell down the stairs.
Well, you'll just have to be more careful, won't you? You can take away.
Don't worry. I will be. Might even start up an accident insurance fund.
What's the matter? Don't you like our new chef's food?
Not hungry. Stomach pumps don't do much for the appetite. Lexi?
What?
Is Alice all right?
She's in solitary, thanks to you, charged with murdering Sam. She didn't try to kill you, you know. It was an accident. She didn't know that stuff was poison.
Yeah, but I thought that...
Yeah, well, you thought wrong. No one knew that stuff was poison until Alice had left the kitchen, then Merv told us.
It's your own stupid fault for being so desperate for a drink.
Didn't mean to lag.
Oh, yeah, sure. Still, it's not my worry. It's yours now.
Just a clue, mate.
Clue. Wonder what it must feel like to be a virgin at 24. What do you reckon, Mr. C?
I wouldn't know.
No, of course you wouldn't. Who would? I reckon you'd have sore hands, Bo.
Come here. Come on, you butter.
All right, Quirk, just get on with your work.
Sure. I'll get you, though. Don't worry about that.
No, you won't. You're one person I'll never turn my back on.
Oh, so good to see you. You look great.
You too, Mum.
Now, tell me everything. How you been?
Fine. Bit of a hassle here and there, but otherwise okay.
What sort of hassle?
Purely physical. Don't worry. I just think I'm going to have to move.
Why?
Skinner and the blokes have dropped around a couple of times. They're starting to bug me again.
Yeah, well, you get on to Alan. He'll help you.
I know, Mum. It's not that bad, really. Anyway, Alan's a great help. But sometimes I just need me mum just to talk to.
There's a guy called Jeff McRae. Now, he's going to be getting out soon. If you need anything, anything at all, don't hesitate to ask him.
Is he one of the guys in here?
Yeah. He's become a very close friend. I'd like you and Alan to meet him.
Why?
I just told you.
That's the only reason.
It's one of the nicest people I've met in a long time. Don't you want to meet him?
It's not that. It just seems funny, that's all. Are you having it off with him or something?
We're close friends, all right?
There's no future in that, Mum.
Thank you for your advice. Look, there's something I want you to do for me. I want you to contact a lady called Caroline Russell. She works for a firm of solicitors called Beasley, Dudley and Grant. Got that?
Yes.
Yep. I want you to tell her that Etty Parslow is innocent and that the department have offered her a ridiculous sum.
About what? I don't understand.
The less you know, the better. Just tell Caroline all that and she'll handle the rest, okay?
Spill the beans.
What's going on?
Haven't you heard? It's about Popeye and Olive Oil.
What about them?
Well, they're both virgins.
Can't say I'm surprised.
No.
Listen, I've got some scores to settle around here, and you're going to help.
Sure. You know you can count on me.
Yeah. Just don't bugger it up this time.
I won't. I promise.
It's a bit hard to explain, love.
I hear you've never had it off with a woman. To be ashamed of. Why don't you come back to me cell and I'll fix you up. Show you a few tricks your mother never thought of.
No thanks. Might catch something.
Not much point in getting married then, is there?
I'm glad you all think it's so funny. Have a good laugh then, go on. I suppose it must be funny to hear that we both decided to wait until we found the right person. And even funnier to hear that we're both going to wait until we get married. It's our right to do what we want with our bodies.
So you can carry on and snigger to your dirty little mind's content. We're happy with the way things are.
Good on you, Marlene.
I couldn't have said it better myself, love.
Myra, mm-hmm. You took one of the strings off my guitar and I tried to get it back, but she was too strong.
You know what that means, don't you?
Yeah. But who's she after first, Frank or me?
Mrs. Reynolds, can you give us a statement regarding Eddie Parslow? Why has it taken so long for Eddie Parslow's case to come
to the Department's notice? What's your view of this gross miscarriage of justice?
No comment.
More jokes about me and Matt.
So what?
So I'm sick of it, that's what. You pull your heads in or I'll do it for you, understand? Hey, look. I'm sorry about the way I was carrying on yesterday.
No, that's okay.
Yeah, sure. I'm gonna ring Mum and Dad as soon as I'm allowed and apologise to them too. I was behaving like a spoiled brat.
You certainly were.
Well, you've made up for it. I wondered why we liked you.
Thanks. Hey, you know, me and Matthew both being virgins, it's pretty funny, isn't it?
Yeah, but I promise I won't laugh. Looks like you're being watched.
Yes, I know.
You want me to nick out and have a look for that guitar string?
No point. Lou could have hidden it anywhere. I might have a talk to our friend over there. She's probably got all the answers.
I just been caught, Mike.
Well, Etty's story's been leaked to the press somehow. I'd say it'd be headlines in tomorrow morning's papers.
Well, that'd put the cat among the pigeons.
To put it mildly, if the department wants to save face, they're going to have to act very quickly.
Well, it's about time.
How'd you go with Keane? She confirmed everything in Ray's letter. So now I've got no choice. I'm going to have to forward it to the department and let them take appropriate action.
Well, that's the end of Joan's career.
I'd say so.
It's rotten timing, though, what with her father's death and all. I mean, much as I'd like to see her go, it does seem a bit cruel.
Well, that's the way it goes.
No, you got it all wrong, Myra.
Have I?
Oh, Lou's not after you, honest.
Ah, don't give me that crap. I know she's got the guitar string, and I know she's got it in for me. Now, a word of warning, Deacon, don't get involved.
Oh, it's not you, Myra. Frank's the one Lou's after. I promise to help her. That's okay, isn't it?
Oh, sure. And after Frank? What then?
Nothing.
You better not be lying, Deacon. Just remember what I've said.
Sweet,
chops on the
flies.
That's why it's called
shoe fly.
Effie,
you come with me. The governor wants to see you.
Oh,
I hope it's good news.
Good luck.
Good luck,
Ed. Yeah. Jeez, hope it is good news for her too.
Yeah. One day I'll tell you about hominy.
What do you want?
I've come to apologise for the things I said in the rec room.
What?
Yeah, I was being a bit of a bitch. I'm sorry. Okay?
Huh. Sure.
And I'd just like to say that I think that what you said took a lot of guts. What you're doing has taken even more guts.
What are you talking about?
Marion Delaney.
Why?
I'm sorry. I mean, you didn't know. It's none of my business then.
What are you talking about? It's about Matthew. I've got a right to know.
Yeah. I hate to tell you this, but your boyfriend's a horse's.
What?
A horse's hoof. A poof.
Come off it, you're just being a bitch again.
Not this time. That's why he's in stir. He was having it off with his boss and they had a bit of a lover's blue. Delaney beat him real bad. He didn't defend himself in court because he didn't want his folks to find out.
I don't believe that.
I'm sorry. You're trying to change him. Shows you got a lot more guts than I gave you credit for. I'll see you.
You're joking.
No, I'm not.
250,000 quid.
A dollars, Etty.
Yeah.
That's the department's offer. And you'll be released within 24 hours.
Oh, I can't believe it. I'm dreaming. Is this really happening, Meg?
It certainly is, and it's not a dream.
Oh, wow.
The only catch is that you have to give us an answer straight away so the department can make a statement to the press.
Oh, well, I have to give a press conference.
Not if you don't want to. But I dare say they'd like to talk to you. Now, I know it's a difficult decision to make with Jan still in hospital.
Oh, no, it's not. No, I'll take it. I agree. Oh, 250 grand. Oh, whoopee!
Hi.
Hi.
Please, it's been going long, actually.
Well, she swallowed it. Think she'll have to Frank. Good. I left a note in her cell saying McCrae wanted to see her urgently after work.
Better go.
One at a time. See you in a minute. You go first.
As far as I can say. Anyway, I might eat for my mum and dad tomorrow.
Yes. Just excuse me for a minute. I'll be back in a sec.
Mummy, see Myra.
No, I don't know where she is.
You okay?
Yes.
Listen, if you're worried about them teasing you...
No, everything's all right. I just have to speak to Jude. Jude, can I see you for a minute?
Oh, yeah, sure. Right about...
Not here, somewhere private.
Oh, okay. Listen, everyone, I've got something to tell you.
Oh, is it about Eddie? What's happening?
Oh, I don't know, Jude, but what I was going to say, that if you're all still interested, I'm prepared to give you tap dancing lessons.
Oh, yeah? Even I'll be in that.
Myra?
Yeah?
Can I see you for a minute?
All right. So I can call you.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too.